Hi everyone, welcome to Engineered Math. In this video, I will teach you about open, closed, and short circuits. Okay, often in circuits, we can encounter the terms open, closed, and short circuits. So it's important for us to know the concepts behind open, closed, and short circuits. And what do they mean in terms of resistance, voltage, and current? Okay, so let's start first with open circuit. So what is an open circuit? So it states here that open circuit is a circuit where there is a break in the path for current to flow. So to illustrate this, let's say we have a simple circuit. Let's say we have a voltage source and we have a switch and there is a load connected, let's say a lamp, across this DC voltage source. So for this figure, it illustrates an open circuit because the switch here is open. So a switch is a good electrical component to represent open, short, and closed circuit. So I use here a switch to open the circuit because when we say open, there is no complete path for the current to flow. So there is a break here for the current to flow. So it cannot flow directly from the voltage source to the lamp and back to the ground because of the break in the circuit with the switch being open. Okay, so by the way, we have two types of current flow in a circuit. So we have the so-called conventional current flow. So conventional current flow means the current starts flowing from the positive polarity of the voltage source going back to the negative polarity. And then the other type of current flow is the electron flow. So the direction of electron flow is opposite the conventional current flow. So it starts from the negative polarity of the source going back to the positive. Because in electron flow, literally, it means that we are referring to the electrons flowing through the circuit. Whereas in conventional current flow, we are referring to the holes or positive charges flowing through the circuit. Okay? So again, this circuit is an open circuit because there is a break in the path for the current to flow, or the voltage source cannot deliver directly energy or power to the load. Okay? Now, let's have the closed circuit. So closed circuit is a circuit where there is a complete path for the current to flow. Okay, so referring to the same figure, so if we try to close now the switch, we see that there is now a complete path for the current to flow. So therefore, it is considered already a closed circuit because the current can flow from the voltage source to the bulb back to the ground. Okay? So the energy from the voltage source is being transferred now to the bulb. So we can see that the bulb can already light up. Okay? Next, what about short circuit? So, short circuit is a direct connection between two points in a circuit, possibly that aren't supposed to be directly connected. Okay, so referring again to the figure. So, suppose we have this figure, but accidentally we short this circuit, meaning we short out the load, or we put a direct connection of wire across the load, or it means that we already shorted the DC source, right? So this is what we call the short circuit. There is a direct connection from the two terminals of the electrical component. So in this case, we shorted the load through this wire, equivalently shorting out this DC source. Okay, so the net effect here is that the light bulb will be turned off. So it is being bypassed and all the current will flow directly through the wires. And in this case, it is unsafe for us to short the DC voltage source because we will send large amounts of electrical energy or current from one side of the power supply to the other. So with nothing in the circuit to limit the current and absorb the electrical energy, heat builds up quickly in the wire and in the power supply. So a short circuit can melt the insulation around the wire and may cause a fire or even an explosion, okay? So, to illustrate the concepts of open, closed, and short circuits, I have here a simple circuit wherein it involves a 2-volt DC source, And across this DC source, there is an LED connected. We also have here two switches. Switch 1, which is in series with the 2-volt DC source, and switch 2, which is parallel to the 2-volt DC source. So for this first case, we have switch 1 open and switch 2 open. So in this figure, it represents an open circuit because as you can see, there is no current flowing through the circuit and even the LED does not light, right? So if I try to close now switch 1, okay, and I run the circuit, you can see that the current now is flowing through the circuit and the LED turns on now. The LED lights up already because as you can see from the animation, there is no current flowing or there is now a closed path for the current to flow through the circuit. Okay? Now, if I try this time to close switch 2, as you can see, the LED turns off. Because the current now is flowing from the 2-volt battery from switch 1 to switch 2 until it goes back to the ground. There is no more current flowing through the LED because the current is flowing through switch 2 and the LED is being bypassed. Here also, you can see that the voltage source becomes red because it means that it is being shorted. So remember that when a voltage source is being shorted, it is delivering a high amount of current. So it's not good to short a power supply. Okay? Now let's define open, closed, and short circuits in terms of resistances, voltages, and currents. So we still have here a voltage source. And across this voltage source, there is a load connected that has a resistance of R. So we also have switch 1 in series with the voltage source and switch 2 in parallel with the voltage source. So let's start with the open circuits. So for the open circuits, referring to the same figure where switch 1 is open, we can define the resistance seen by the voltage source R is equal to infinity. Okay, so when you say equal to infinity, the resistance is so high that the current that will flow through the circuit is negligible or approximately zero, ideally. So that I is equal to 0. So if you try to apply Ohm's law here, remember Ohm's law is what? I is equal to voltage over resistance. So if you try to substitute the value, so let's say V is fixed at V volts, but then since we have an open circuit, we consider R as infinity, so we substitute the value of R as infinity. So infinity is the ideal value for open circuit. So it means that any constant V divided by a large amount, let's say infinity, it will be ideally equal to zero. So that's why current will be zero for open circuit. And there is no delivered energy or power to the load. Okay? How about for closed circuit? So this time, if we now close the switch 1, okay? So there will be now a current I that will flow through the circuit through the resistor R from positive polarity of the voltage source to the ground. So we can apply here Ohm's law. So Ohm's law will apply now here. So therefore, we'll just follow whatever is the value of the resistance. So it's R, right? And if the voltage source is V volt, we can define the current as by Ohm's law again, V over R. So it depends now on the value of R and the voltage source. Okay? Now, if we have the short circuits, so this time, let's now close this switch 2, making the load R shorted, equivalently the voltage source shorted as well. We can say now that the resistance seen by the voltage source is 0. So ideally, if there is a short circuit, the resistance is 0. So therefore, if you try to solve for the current, I is equal to what? V over R again, right? So substituting the value, let's say we have a V volt over the resistance of 0. So it will approach infinity, the current. So that when we have short circuit, the current that will flow approaches infinity, ideally. So that's why, like what I've said, it's dangerous to have a short circuit in a circuit, particularly for power supply. Okay? Likewise, the voltage across the shorted load, V, will now be equal to 0 since we are multiplying the resistance R0 to the current. since we have I times R, right? And R is 0 for short circuit. So 0 times I is 0. Okay? So to illustrate the concepts for open, closed, and short circuits, let's solve some example. For the given circuit below, so we have this given circuit. So we have a 25 voltage source. We have series to parallel resistors R1, R2, and R3. And we also have switches. So initially, switch 1 is closed. We also have switch 2 initially open, and switch 3 initially closed, and switch 4 initially open. So we have different questions. So for A, what is the total current IT for the circuit? So if we try to consider the original circuit, let's try to find the total current IT. So let's copy the circuit. Okay, so we can find first the total current RT. So we see that it is a series to parallel connection of resistors. So we combine first this parallel resistors R2 and R3. So we have 1 all over 1 over R2 is 10 ohm plus 1 over R3 is 15 ohm. So using calculator, it is equal to what? 6 ohms. And then it is in series with a 5 ohm resistor. So we add 5 ohm, it is... So we add 6 ohms plus 5 ohms, it is 11 ohms. Now to find the total current IT, we just use Ohm's law. So VT over RT. So our input voltage VT is 25 volts divided by the total resistance RT is 11 ohms. So 25 divided by 11 is approximately 2.27 amps. So therefore, IT is 2.27 amps. Okay? Now, for letter B, we have what is the current through R1 if S1 is open? Okay, so referring to the same figure here, so if we try to open now S1, okay, so we can see that there will be now open circuit for the network. So, meaning there will be no total current that can flow through the circuit. Or our total current IT will now be 0. So, since the total current is 0, there will be no energy or current that can flow through this part of the circuit, the resistor network. So, therefore, the current through R1 will also be 0. Okay. Next, for C, what is the current through R2 if switch 2 is closed? Okay, so let's just copy first the circuit. Okay, so the condition for letter C is that we will close switch 2. So therefore, if we close switch 2, as shown, what is the effect now to the circuit? So we will short out this resistor R1, meaning this whole parallel resistor of a wire and resistor R1 will all equivalent to 0 ohm. So therefore, we can replace this resistor R1 by just a wire since it's already shorted. Okay? After doing that, we are left with parallel circuits, right? So we have two parallel resistor R2 and R3 across a 25 volt DC source. So we are asked to find the current through R2. So let's say I sub 2. So we can just apply Ohm's law, right? Since we have R2 equal to 10 ohms and we have a voltage source, 25 volts, so that will be also the voltage across R2 because we have parallel circuit. So V2 is equal to 25 volts. We can solve for I2 using Ohm's law. So V2 over R2. So we have 25 volts divided by 10 ohms. Using calculator, it is equal to what? It is 2.5 volts. Amps. Okay, next for D, what is the voltage drop across R1 if S3 is open? Okay, so let's copy again the circuit. So the condition for letter D is that we will open switch 3. So initially S3 is closed, so when we open it, okay. So, if we have open now S3, what is the effect on the circuit? So, we can see that this resistor R3 can be disconnected to the whole circuit because in this case, it will now be floating or there is no direct connection now for this resistor artery within the circuit. So we can equivalently remove resistor artery from the circuit because it has no use anymore. It's already floating. Okay? So we are now left with series connection of resistors R1 and R2 connected across 25 volt source. So we want to find the voltage across R1, right? So we can apply voltage divider rule. So remember my video about voltage divider rule? So we can find the voltage drop across resistor R1, let's say V1, equal to the resistance of R1, which is 5 ohms, over the sum of the resistances of the circuit. So we have R1 plus R2, right? So 5 ohms plus 10 ohms. Then multiplied by the voltage source V times 25 volts. So what is the value of V1? So it's approximately 8.33 volts. Okay? Now for the last letter, letter E, what is the total current IT if switch 4 is closed? Okay, so let's copy the circuit again. So the condition now for E is that we will close switch 4. So initially, switch 4 is open, right? So when we close it, okay, so the circuit will look like this now. Okay, so what do you notice after closing switch 4? We now have a short circuit, meaning this whole network of resistors acting as the load for the circuit is being bypassed, right? So that the total resistance as seen by this 25 volt source is only this short circuit or this wire, right? So therefore, applying what we've discussed for the concept of short circuit, what will be the total current IT now? So IT is ideally infinity, right? So there will be a large amount of current that will flow this time only through this circuit, which is like what I've said is not good for the circuit because we have an infinite amount of current. Okay? Okay, so I think that's it for this video, open, close, and short circuits. So I hope you learned something from this video and thank you for watching.